Oh, brother, what do we get to do now? Well, the next thing we got to do is, before I float everything out on the floor, I'm going to put some self-leveling material, some surfacing material on the floor. But before I do that, I want to put masking tape up along the baseboard, because the baseboard is down tight to this particular floor. And so my theory is, I want to put the blue tape, but obviously the blue tape is not going to stick until all this baseboard is clean. So now I've got another step I got to do. I'm going to take some cleaner. What am I going to use for this? I usually use Simple Green, but I don't have any with me. I'm going to use this stuff called Medina Orange Oil. It's natural, biodegradable, super concentrated, multi-purpose cleaner, degreaser. Degreaser makes 64 quarts. This one bit makes 64 quarts. And so you take a spray bottle, and I poured maybe about that much in the bottom of this, okay, and then filled up the rest. And this is that orange cleaner, okay? So now I'm just gonna go along here. I don't think I should really have to show you this, but I'm just gonna get it going here. I got a big sponge and a nice bucket here. What I could do first is just kind of wipe off this a little bit. No, I'm not gonna get everything. See how dirty that is? There's no way masking tape is gonna stick on it. Then I can kind of spray this stuff on there and wipe it off. It's got a nice smell to it too. Nice orangey smell. I don't think I have to get every single little speck off of here. Mainly, I want to get this all uniform, so when I put the masking tape on there, it's going to stick. Okay? And besides, here's something else you have to keep in mind. I've got to do this up high enough. So I'm going to wipe off the entire baseboard. Even though I'm going to use like an inch and a half masking tape, the blue tape I'm going to use, I'm going to wipe off this whole thing. Because once, man, just that, I'm out of breath. Once I get everything done, once I float these floors out, then I'm going to stain it to make it look like concrete stain and sealer. But before I do that, once I put this masking tape down, before I put the surfacing material on, then I think I'm gonna leave that. Then I'm gonna put another piece of masking tape on top of that. And that's why I need the rest of this area clean, because I want that masking tape to stick there. Because then I'm gonna take some plastic and I'm gonna cut it like in 12 inch strips, 16 inch wide strips or so. And then I'm gonna run it underneath the piece of masking tape. So I'll put another layer of masking tape on there, bend it out a little bit, put the plastic on there, and then fold the plastic up to about 16, 18 inches up the wall, all the way around where I'm gonna have to stain this floor. Yeah, all the way. Okay, that's a little project in itself, just getting all that masking tape on. I'll have to tie those curtains up and up high enough so they stay out of the way, and go all the way around this room. Then I'll have to put plastic up on that door there. I'll have to put a layer of masking tape on that, laminate, and then extend the plastic out maybe a foot and a half there. Because when I install the stain, I'm gonna put it on with a Hudson sprayer. And it's gonna be kind of cool to watch that. You keep watching my videos, and you'll see all about how to do that, okay? If you're so inclined to wanna do that to a project of yours, back room of yours, the den, the office, kids' playroom, your storage area, your garage area, you know, where you got your workbench, your tools, whatever you wanna do, okay? The first thing we gotta do is keep cleaning this baseboard. And so I'm gonna do that, and see, I'm working in tandem. Remember, I just got done. If you didn't watch that last video, I just painted all this baseboard down in this hallway, and I've got the paint can ready for my next coat, because I'm trying to refinish that base while I'm waiting for that to dry, I'm out here. Okay, that way I don't have to stand there twiddling my thumbs and watch the paint dry for an hour. Okay, work strategically and you'll get her done that much quicker. Okay, so I'm just gonna wipe off the excess of the dirt, and I swept it off too as best I could initially just with the hand broom. You could take a crummy paintbrush too, use that as your broom. Flip this over every once in a while. I like using these big sponges. You can get them at the hardware store. Now I'm spraying the orange oil on there. And you know, I can let that sit like that and go on to my next piece of base, let's say, and then come back and wipe this. But it seems to do pretty good without really waiting. I'm trying to get the majority of it off so that the masking tape, the blue masking tape, is going to dry on there properly. It's going to stick. You know? All in the project. When you think, you see a project in front of you, and you think, oh yeah, I'm only have to do this, this, and this, and we'll be done. Usually, just remember, usually, your projects can extend themselves without you even knowing it. But see, certain things make sense when you put it all together. So when you think about stuff and you think you have to do a little bit more, just do it because you need to, and that's just part of the way it is.